Hi folks, my tea is piping hot and it's still 3 o'clock in the morning. It's not even 6:30 yet and I'm getting ready to go out the door. Right, part two, Yola. I spent a bit of time with it last night and I also spent a bit of time on the IRC chat. And I've got to admit that if it wasn't for some of the people on that chat, I would have been struggling with a few things about the Yola. But they were there, very helpful, very friendly, which is exactly what you need from a support vector, for want of a better way of putting it. Now, as you guys know about me, I'm up to my arse in it at the moment, and although I've developed for other platforms, I've never developed for the mobile phone before, any mobile phone. So I don't think I'm going to be much use to the Yola movement in the short term as a developer. I'm probably going to be more use as a sort of bridge between userland and devland. Because to be perfectly honest, in my personal experience, developers tend to think one way and users will tend to think a different way. I don't know whether it's different ways of thinking or what. I haven't got a clue. But I think if I start using the phone and put forward to the dev team and support team, look, this is what's being important to me using the phone in day-to-day use, and see what they respond to that. Because there is always the risk when a project is a passion that you follow your passion and what other people need doesn't happen or is on the fringes. And really, that's what needs to be in the center, because ultimately, in order to go forward, Yola needs the kind of user base and people wanting to use its product that the likes of Android and iOS have. That's where it needs to be. And if it follows the desires of the few who are putting the energy into it, then it's only going to serve those people and it's not going to serve society at large. What came is not, you know, it's not as polished as I'd hoped. There's a lot missing, there's an awful lot missing, which, to be perfectly honest, was to be expected. I was hoping that it would be a bit more polished than it is, but we're going to see what happens. Nevertheless, I don't think that many people will be able to use this as their day-to-day final phone at the moment, but nevertheless, I'm going to try. I'm going to see where it comes up short. Fortunately, I've got the works phone, so if I have problems with this, it's not going to handicap me. And I'll still have the S2 with me, because one of the other crucial things that actually helped me out last night in getting home in the dark was turn-by-turn navigation, which I don't think this has at the moment. I am having problems with some of the gestures, which is one of the key things on here, particularly some of the gestures with my hand shape and how I'm holding it. To close an application, I've got to flip it and then attempt to pull down with a thumb, and that pull down to close an application is awkward. What I've got to do instead is, if I just wake it up, right, let's say I've got an application here, this is the settings, but it's easier to just push it to one side and then go in and close it that way. It's easier to do that than it is to bring the thumb down from the top when you're in the app, because some of the apps, like this one, it has a pull down as part of the app. Hello? You know, there's a pull down as part of it, and if you miss to come down for the overall, you know, and because of the holding position, it's difficult. And indeed, some of the swipe gestures, I hope that there's a left-handed option in here. Otherwise, left-handed people may find it a bit more difficult. I don't know. That would need a few people to work it out. It is a different way of thinking. I'm going to go through, in another video, I'll go through some of the apps and bits, but it does look like if you want to get anywhere, you're going to have to. Oh, can I enter the pull down from there? No, I can't. No, in the top menu here, there is actually a pull down, and I was actually trying to figure out if I could actually access the pull down from there, but I can't. I'll take more video close-up shots of this in the future. Unfortunately, another problem is that it doesn't seem to work that way, which is a pain because when it's in something like a holder, it doesn't flip its orientation to work with you when it's operating in landscape. It always assumes that the user is going to be using it like that. That's going to have a few issues. But yeah, I think at the moment the best thing that I can do is be a pain in the neck. In the best possible way, of course. And to. Why is Bluetooth off? Did I turn Bluetooth off? That's another annoyance. This screen here goes to sleep too fast. It doesn't listen to the overall setting, which is 2 minutes, which is starting to be an annoyance. Yes, for some reason I turned Bluetooth off. Oh, of course I turned Bluetooth off because I'm going to have to fire up the headset, and this is already paired. So we'll go through it in due course, but if you're going to go for the Yola at the moment, I would say it's very much still a developer phone. If you're going to use it, it covers a lot of the basics. I mean, I've got Firefox on there, Skype is on there, although I haven't fired it up yet. It has a calendar, clock. There is turn-by-turn direction on the map structure. I've got it hooked up to email. There are a few bugs in email, which we worked out last night. The gallery, it's starting, it's difficult. The back buttons were easy. It allowed easier navigation. All this extra tapping and swiping is going to take a while to get used to. You've got all the usual stuff like a calculator and the rest of that jazz. Is there any? No, there's no pull down. What I'm looking for, is there a pull up? Yes, there is a pull up for notifications. I'm looking for a scientific mode. Oh, is that a settings button? No, it isn't. It's a copy paste button. Okay, there doesn't seem to be a scientific mode on this yet. But I dare say that stuff like that will come. So if you are desperate for an alternative to iOS and Android, then this is to a degree a viable alternative if you want basic operation. If you want to be flush and flash with the apps, maybe not the phone for you at the moment, but I think that in a year it will get there. There are two stores in here, one of which is the Yola store, and the other one is a link to the Yandex store. And it's, for me, it's coming down to a matter of trust. At the moment, I trust the Yola store more than I trust the Yandex store. Various stores have got trust issues. I mean, if you're in on the IT news, you will know all the crap that's going on, to put a long story short. Oh, that's the volume button. I keep going for the volume button instead of going for the off button because I just want it to go to sleep, and I keep going hitting the up volume button. On the Androids, it's more easy because the volume buttons are on the other side to the power button. That's going to be an annoyance, but I think that will probably be something for consideration on a future phone. The other half I haven't really investigated yet. There does seem to be a link to the other half which fired off at some point, but because it wasn't connected to the Wi-Fi. There are backlashes against some things, like I happen to run Mac filtering. I know it's easy for hackers to hack Mac filtering, but it makes life difficult for the amateur. And when you start up the Eula, and it needs to connect via Wi-Fi for part of the startup process, it doesn't tell you its MAC address. It doesn't tell you its wireless MAC address. So I suggested that, and I basically got a, well, you do know that MAC address filtering is not secure and blah de blah de blah, which I expected from a bunch of developers, but users who are running MAC filtering, you know, and this I think is going to be the primary battle that I'm going to have, overcoming the developer mentality, for want of a better word. They need to think about user land, and that is probably where I am going to annoy the hell out of them. Yes, but your average user. I mean, I think it did me good being stuck in support for so long. And I wouldn't say being stuck in support, because if you're a support kind of person, then it can be a very rewarding place to be. But I think it does wind up with you, if you've got a foot in both camps, you wind up being a friend and an enemy to both. So we're going to see what happens. My main mission is going to be to make this my primary phone, even though it's very much not as polished as I expected, and see what we can find out. I've already got a reputation among some suppliers, because if there are any bugs in their kit or ways that it's not working how it should really, then I find the things that they've missed. Boy, do I find the things that they've missed. Not only that, I find the things that they can't replicate in the lab, because they are working in the lab. That's the whole point. So we'll take it as it comes. If you want an alternative to Android and iOS, and you just want basic functionality, then I think the Eula is worth a punt. If you want a functioning phone that's app happy, I'd say leave it a year. The stuff from the Yandex store and the compatibility of Eula with Android applications, it works. It definitely works. I got Firefox from the Yandex store, and I got Skype from the Yandex store. I fired up Firefox. It seems to have synced. There's some stuff that's not working, because now that I have synced it, I try and go back into sync to sort out some of the options, and now this option is not supported. I think it is better to go for the apps which will hopefully appear in the Eula store sooner rather than later, which are written to interact with Sailfish as opposed to Android. At the moment, I'm viewing the Android applications purely as a way to get me around some stuff. I did try some of the video stuff, and FLVs are not supported, as is the other codec, which is also not supported on Android. I'll tell you what, time's marching on. I need to head out the door. So I will give you the information on that when I settle down and record and show you the interface and take you around to some of this stuff, because it is a different mental way of working. One of the immediate things is the corners down here. They're not resting as easily in my hand as the curvatures of the iPhone and a number of the Androids. There's a lot about this which will mean relearning, and getting used to some of the quirks. That thumb to the top really is getting to be a bugbear, but I haven't even had it 24 hours yet. I've got to give myself time, I've got to give it time, I've got to give the developers time. I think, from what I've seen so far, that Sailfish will be one to watch. And I will be doing what I can to pressurize some of the manufacturers into at least, at the very least, releasing their apps onto the Yandex store in Android compatibility mode. Because unfortunately, I think it'll be a while before any of the major developers will be redoing their apps specifically for Yola. The open source community section might, but the likes of Skype, the suppliers from whom I have the I'm trying not to use their or the product's name, but we have a control system on the phones for the cloud telephony. I don't think that they will put that on there easily either. And there's you know, as I go through my Android and go through the apps that I use on a regular basis, they're not there. They're not even in the Yandex store. So that those are hurdles to overcome. And if anything's going to hold it back, I think it's either going to be developer attitude, ignoring the user side of things, or making assumptions about the user side of things, and the application support. We'll see what happens. I'm definitely pressuring Orange to get some support. From my point of view, it is a real it's a real shame that Yola don't support UMA in this phone. For me, in the country, it's very much, not only in the country is it very much a necessity, but also in other buildings it's very much a necessity, because, you know, a lot of us are now turning to the Wi-Fi to support mobile comms where the mobile phone signals are still not extending. We are having need to use data, and 4G isn't there, and 3G is still patchy and relatively weak. Heck, in some cases, even getting a mobile signal with any fashion in some of the buildings is a nightmare. So UMA support is going to be badly missed on this phone, but we'll take it as it comes. I'd say that if you were a developer and you want to make a splash, I would say that the Yola platform, the Sailfish platform, is probably the place to do it, because iOS, Android environments, they are so they are just so saturated that your chances are basically minimal, in my personal opinion. I mean, I've been to the Play Store, I've been to other stores, and it is just, what? Here you have a chance of a smaller community, a more enthusiastic community, in which to pitch up and work. And I think that this will, I really do hope that Yola and the Sailfish go mainstream. I really do hope that it happens. But it will be a few years before it happens. It will be a few years before it happens. I think the apps are very much going to be needed in order to help it make it. But as a developer side, if I was on the developer side, I would be looking at this and thinking, this community is small enough to actually make a name for myself and get my work out in front of people's noses without it getting swamped. It's going to be interesting to see where it goes. And I'm going to take the risk. and convert my sim down. The new sim is on its way. I'm going to convert the new sim down and make the Yola my primary personal phone. There is still lots to discover. There is shed loads to discover, the other half for one. But we'll take it as it comes. So I'll see you on the next video, folks. Take care and give me a couple of days. I'm going to hope on the weekend that I can find some time to point the video camera at the front of the phone and show you roughly how it works and what's available. Till then, see you later. Bye.